We moved into this house in 2010, decided we needed some more room, so we started the journey of looking for a builder. Spoke to a builder I'd previously used on a job at Salisbury. He came round, had a look, too hard. Spoke to another guy, spoke to a draftsman architect. He did some plans for us, we weren't happy. Moved on to found Sovereign in the neighbourhood, Tarragindi. Had a meeting with John, gave him our ideas. Him and his draftsman, John, came up with some other ideas to add on top of ours, and we went from there.
Oh, we had a really great experience. Everybody on site from John, both the Johns, the tradesmen, the individual subbies that would be on site, they were all very friendly, turned up on time. Just to the girls in the office that we spoke to, everything was seamless. You often hear of people who are going through a major renovation like ours, and they think, oh, what's going to go wrong? Well, that wasn't our experience at all.
And being local was just the icing on the cake. Strengths of Sovereign are easy. They do everything. You have an initial thought and they'll put it into place for you. They'll do the plans as you want them. So you've got your ideas. They've had the experience. They'll come in over the top of your plans and say, you can do this, change this, do this, this will work better. But it's a collaboration basically with them.
And tweaked as well, what you've, you know, what your idea made it better, and
Yeah,
even
during the process, it wasn't too hard to change things if you had to.
nothing was too hard, basically. So our ideas just made so much better, and yeah, everything's just been fabulous. And yeah, I can't say enough about it. Basically, we wasted our money going through another architect first. He drew up plans and it was a complete waste of money. We should have just rung them first and saved our
Yeah,
time and money.
he had his ideas on what the house should be. We had ours. Sovereign listened to our ideas first. That was great. They just came round. We sat at the kitchen bench over there, had a cup of coffee, went over the plans, made
Sorry,
some.
it was a beer.
Oh,
was
no.
no coffee involved.
Don't tell us it was a
Cut.
beer.
Yeah, we sat up the kitchen, had a beer over the plans. John had his red pen. We made some changes, alterations here and there. That's John the draftsman, made some changes here and there. He took them back, redrew them, brought them back to us. Might have had another beer. And just sort of finalised the plans. Very friendly.
So it was a very comfortable process, obviously, around the kitchen bench, and still a very professional end product. While it was a comfortable, casual process, it was still a very professional end product that we wouldn't have had we have just said, well, this is what we want, can you do this? And that was just drawn up, it wouldn't have been as good a product. So we were very delighted to find this house, and when we did, I wanted to pay respect to as much of the original architecture as we could, to the point where I went to the John Oxley Library and tried to dig out original plans, original maps, and things like that, because it had been changed over the years, as many houses have. This one in particular was built in 1927, as I discovered. So I was very interested in keeping breezeways and keeping things as original as possible while still trying to accommodate our modern lifestyle. And then even with the raising, I sort of wanted to then mirror as much as I could still downstairs. And Sovereign were very great with that. They're very understanding. They weren't trying to suppress that and saying, oh no, you really want to do it this way. Sovereign were brilliant with, you know, listening to how particular I was. I wanted particular colours, I wanted to have certain architraves and certain breezeways and these sorts of things, and nothing was too much trouble with accommodating all those particular things that were very important to me with this house, because this house was particularly important.